What is good, guys? We're here with more Smoke Snake Draft. We have Black Goblin versus Ray Scarface, if I recall correctly, for phase 3. So we're gonna rewatch turn 1 where Scissor just dies to HP fire. I'm pretty sure Black Goblin predicted this Greninja to go for spikes, because he does have a Gastron in the back that just walls Greninja otherwise. Like, unless the Greninja has hidden power grass or grass knot, Gastron completely walls it. So I'm pretty sure he just predicted a spike, and I assume this Greninja is either expert build or a Z-move with 3 attacks and spikes. Getting rid of Scizor is really nice for Ray. Freeze up his Clefable. I mean, Scizor was not the biggest threat to him because he does have a Celesteela and a Venusaur, but it's nice to get rid of that. I assume Black Oblivion is now gonna go into his Kyurem or his Gastron. Because Kyurem kinda just gets a kill. Looking at Ray's team, he does not have a Kyurem switch in. Clefable does run Fist Death in Sun and Moon, which means Ice Beam would destroy the Clefable if it's a Life Orb Kyurem, and if it's Z-move, it also just gets a kill. But I'm thinking that it's Z-move Landorus. I know Black Oblivion loves Z-move Landorus, he uses it quite often. And I guess the Lily would be Scarf and the Tita would be Bandit, that's my guess. So I see Kyurem just comes out here and gets a kill. I don't see why you wouldn't go Kyurem and just take your kill, because Greninja is probably HP fire, then either Ice Beam, Hydro Pump, Spikes, and in the last slot maybe, I don't know, there's a few options. Could be Low Kick, could be Gang Shot, but as long as it's not Low Kick, Kyurem walls this pretty well, and Kyurem just clicks Ice Beam here and collects a kill. Like, I don't see what he's gonna switch into. I guess he could sack the Venusaur. Celesteela is important for Ray to check Landorus and potentially also check Bantar and check Tapu Lele. So he's definitely not going Celesteela. I'm guessing the Garchomp is maybe Scarf on Ray's side because the Greninja is HP fire. Oh, also that's what I meant to say, to add turn 1. Black Oblivion should just click Ice Beam here. But turn 1, I also think that Black Oblivion might have thought that this Greninja might be Choice Scarf and they don't carry HP fire. Or he predicted the spike, one of the two. But yeah, I'm thinking the Garchomp is Scarf. I know a version of this team where it's Citrus Berry Garchomp, but I think that's the NGMP version. I'm actually not sure who made this team originally. But yeah, you just click Ice Beam here and you get your kill, because Greninja is not gonna stay in unless it has a Low Kick. And even that is not gonna Okori Kyurem. I think you sack the Venusaur because it doesn't do that much overall, and you need the other mons more than you need the Venusaur. Like, it should be Scarf Chomp if it's not Scarf Greninja, because otherwise he's really weak to Volcarona. And he just needs some speed control. It's not only about being weak to Volk. The Clefable is gonna be Rocks for sure, and the Reuniclus is... There could be two options. It's either Defensive Reuniclus with Recover, Calm Mind, Focus Blast, and Psychic Step. A Focus Blast slash Energy Ball, one of the two. Or the other option would be Trick Room Reuniclus with 3 attacks. There's still a slight chance that it's Z-move Reuniclus, but it could also be Z-move Greninja, I'm not sure about that yet. But yeah, I would take the Venusaur if I'm Ray here. You just have to choose your fodder, because I don't think he has a move to hit the Kyurem with the Greninja. He does U-turn. Okay, so we know that he's most likely U-turn, HP fire, spikes, and either Ice Beam or Hydro Pump. I was not sure about the last move. I was thinking Low Kick or Gang Shot are options. If it was Low Kick, he could have stayed in. But yeah, Black Lane does reveal that he's Life Orb Kyurem, and Venusaur is going to get sacked off here. He's just going to click Ice Beam again. Obviously, Ray still doesn't have a switch in. Nothing changed. Ice Beam is really free here, and the Venusaur is going to get sacked off. Makes sense, because Venusaur, besides beating Gastrodon, it doesn't really beat much on Black Oblivion's team. I think it loses 1v1 to Bantar, because Bantar has amazing speed death in the sand. Venusaur Synthesis does not heal much sand, much health back in the sand. And Stone Edge from Choice Bantita beats Venusaur 1v1. And also Venusaur loses to Kyurem, loses to Tapu Lele. And he has Celesteela for Lele. And if the Lando is Skystruck, the Venusaur also loses to that. Or if it's any SD Lando, it doesn't have to be Skystruck, also loses to that. Now he goes to Clefable. I assume Black Oblivion is gonna either just Ice Beam or maybe switch into Landorus. So Ray should just click Moonblast here, because this Kyurem is a big threat to his team and you don't want to play around with a big threat. So I know this is Rocks Clef and he would like to get his Rocks up, but I think he's forced to Moonblast here. He doesn't really lose much, because even if Black Olivine switches out, he can still get the rocks up the next turn, so he should just Moonblast this turn, as Ice Beam does a lot. Confabulous back at around half health after getting some leftovers recovery, and Tita is gonna come out and gonna click Stone Edge now. Briscavis is most likely gonna switch into his Garchomp here, and from that damage we will be able to tell if it's Choice Band T-Tar, as that is definitely Choice Band and it's offensive Garchomp. So Black Alien's Landris is gonna come out here, or Gastrodon, most likely Landris, as he can either go for, I was gonna say maybe he has Rocks on Chomp, but Rocks are on Clef, as I said that earlier. I wasn't sure. So he has Toxic Chomp. Yeah, that is used sometimes on Scarf. It's not 100% Scarf, but I'm still thinking that it's Scarf Chomp. So the Celesteela is gonna come out here. Black Olivine can either go for Rocks, predicting the Celesteela to come out, or he can go for SD if he has that, which would be a cool option. As you see, it's SD, so it's most likely Z-move Landris. If it's Continental Crush, it's really dangerous, as Ray goes for Protect, predicting Z-move, as Black Olivine gets the Rocks up, gets the play correct. So now Ray switches Scouting for the Z, as Black Olivine goes for the Z. I assume it's versus Continental Crush, exactly, because I don't think he would go for Sky Strike versus a Celesteela. I think he would go for Smackdown first. Like the way he SD'd up versus the Celesteela, or like knowing there's a Celesteela in the back, kind of told us that he was Continental Crush. So now he goes into Gastrodon and he reveals Hydro Pump. So he showed Hydro Pump, U-turn, and HP Fire, and I assume the last move is Spikes. So Black Alien can just go for Scald here. He just got a special attack boost with the Gastrodon's ability. I forgot the exact name. Storm Drain, and now he can just spam Scald here, because plus one Scald would do a good chunk to Clef, and they would be forced to soft boiled. I don't even know if Clefable can heal, can take it well. So Ray is gonna soft boiled up. He did get up a spike, but his Greninja died. I mean, to be fair, Greninja was walled by Gastrodon the entire game anyway. It was just nice to get up spikes, but it did get a kill turn one on the Scissor, which was nice. But I think Black Olivine is still in a better position overall, as he does go on the top of Lele. I was thinking either Lele or Tita was his play there. And Ray Scarface is now gonna go into Celesteela, most likely, because he doesn't want to take a Psychic from this Tabulele. A Scarf Psychic would do a lot to Clefable, because like I said earlier already, they run Fist Death and Sun Moon to check stuff like Zygarde. So he does double into his Bantar, I think, predicting the Celesteela. Yeah, because Bantar beats Celesteela 1-on-1. Ray is gonna protect to Scald what it locks itself into. Most likely it's gonna be Stone Edge. I think he only used one Stone Edge so far, so he has 7 more Stone Edge PP. So after he protects here, Tita is gonna have 6 more Stone Edge PP. And Celesteela is most likely gonna take like 60% from a Bandit Stone Edge. If it's mixed defensive, maybe 65. So I think Ray is gonna go for a Leech Seed here to get some health back. And he also kinda has to hope for some Stone Edge misses, because this Tita is just a really big threat to his team. And as long as Black Oblivion can connect all his Stone Edges, I think this game is pretty much in his favor. I'm actually not sure if this game matters. I think it's already decided which team moves on to the next round of Snake, or to Snake. I think the next round is semifinals. This is phase 3. And yeah, Ray has a pretty bad record at the moment. I think he has been getting hacked some games. Yeah, it's definitely rough. I remember when he did super well in SPL, and now he didn't do that well at all. But yeah, he should just go for Leech Seed, because I don't think Heavy Slam is the play. I think Tita would only take like maybe half from Heavy Slam. That's a head calc. I don't know the exact calc. And Leech Seed would help him to get some health back and then protect the next turn and maybe hope for a miss. So it does 67. I was gonna say 60 to 65. And now Celesteela is gonna protect again. And I think he needs a double protect, or he has to hope for a miss. Otherwise, he has to sack something. As Black Alien predicts the protect goes into his Landris. And I think Black Oblivion is just gonna click Stone Edge here, because there's no point in SDing, because the Celesteela can go for Leech Seed slash Heavy Slam. Most likely Leech Seed, since he was intimidated. So there was no point in SDing up. I think just Stone Edging was the correct play. And now he can just protect here. Ray can protect here to get some more health back. I think Black Oblivion is just gonna sack his Landorus. And then he's gonna go into Bantar the next turn. Because I don't think the Celesteela is gonna be out of range from Bantar, because if it protects here, that means it cannot protect the next turn, which means we saw Bandit Stone Edge do 67 earlier, and it's definitely gonna kill the Celesteela after Leech Seed recovery and leftovers. So I think Black Alien sacks his land here and goes on the Bantar, and as long as he hits his Stone Edge, he gets a kill. Yep. He could also... Nah, going into Gastrodon afterwards is not the play, because that would let Ray, if he doesn't get burned, then he could Leech Seed the Gastrodon and get more health back. And Celesteela is annoying for Black Oblivion. So he definitely has to sack Lando here. Going to Bantar afterwards. As Ray is thinking about his play here, but... I guess he could potentially go into Clefable, but if he switches his Celesteela out, he's at 26% after rocks, which means it's too low. I think he has to protect it. Health on his Celesteela is really important. Celesteela is pretty much the mon that puts in the work for Ray, because Reuniclus is not going to win this game with the Bantar and Black Oblivion side. Even if it's a Trick Room Reuniclus, that means it gets walled most likely by the Gastrodon, and Gastrodon can stall at the Trick Room. And if it's a Karma Reuniclus, then it gets destroyed by Crunch from Bantar and put into range from any other move if it can even live a Bannet Crunch. So now Tita comes out. If Black Oblivion misses this Stone Edge, he's in a really bad position. So he just has to go for Edge and connect here. We saw earlier that 67, so Celesteela is in range. Ray has to maybe hope for a double protect slash for a Stone Edge miss. Otherwise, it's looking bleak for Ray. Yeah, I don't think Ray can win this as long as the Stone Edge connects. Afterwards, Ray, if the Stone Edge connects here and the Celesteela dies, afterwards he can, I guess, go Clefable, and we shall see that. It depends on the Reuniclus set. If the Reuniclus is... But I don't think, like I said already earlier, Reuniclus is not going to be winning this game. Because if it's defensive, the Tita is going to switch out, come back later and click Crunch. So he does not get a double protect and the Stone Edge does connect. So he goes into Clefable here. Black Oblivion needs this for the Reuniclus, but I think he's just going to Stone Edge because he's out of range for Moonblast. I think Moonblast only does like 38% to Bantar, something like that. That's a head count, maybe a little bit less. Like 30-ish to 40-ish, that's my guess. So Ray could maybe spam Softbolt here, because he kind of wants to get, like, run the Tita out of Stone Edges. He could also go for Rocks, and I guess hope for a miss. Because Stone Edge clearly 2-hit KOs Clef. I think it does around 60% to Clef. And he has been connecting a lot of his edges, so I guess Ray's mindset here is he will eventually miss one. Yeah, Ray's either gonna Rocks here or go for Moonblast. I mean, Moonblast would be nice, because it should 2-hit KO for sure, yeah. But yeah, Black Alien can still definitely stay in here. If the Clef goes for Moonblast and he misses, he's in a really bad position. Because if he loses his T-Tar, Reuniclus is definitely a threat. So he does connect the Edge. Let's see if he Rocks or if he Moonblast. Okay, that did 75. Okay, that did way more than I expected. Wow. He did softball up. Okay, so he stays out of range, and Tita only has 3 Stone Edges left. So I assume he's gonna softball again and hope for a miss. Or he's gonna Rocks here. No, I guess he's gonna Rocks here, and then he's gonna hope for a miss next turn. So Tita has 2 Stone Edges left. He has been connecting all his edges, so this Tita is really well trained. I don't think switching out is the play for Black Oblivion, because Clefable would softball and get all his health back, so he just has to connect, and he does connect. And now this game is over, because you just switch out the Tita into the Gastrodon, and you come back later and click Crunch and you end the game. And even if Crunch doesn't kill the Reuniclus, it puts it in range from Tapu Lele's Moonblast. So the game is over. So Black Oblivion just switches out here into Gastrodon, as Ray Scarface is either going to Calm Mind or Trick Room, depending on his Reuniclus set. He does have Trick Room, so it's most likely Trick Room 3 attacks Reuniclus. As he has Psychic and should just recover here. He does get a Spadef drop, but it doesn't matter. Gastrodon can either recover spam here to stall out the Trick Room. Yeah, I think he just recover again here to stall out Trick Room turns. And whenever Trick Room ends and Black Oblivion gets Tita in on turn... Like, pretty much, he has to... I think he doesn't even have to get his Tita in. I think Gastrodon just beats Reuniclus one-on-one. If he wants to get rid of the Spadef drop, I guess he could switch... He's just gonna recover here, right? He Earthquake, okay. He gets a crit. Maybe he's gonna switch into his Tapu Lele to get rid of the Spadef drop. I mean, there's no way Black Abaddon loses this game unless he misplays at this point. It's just a matter of playing it safe at the end. Do you go Lily here? I'm trying to think. I think Lily is a fine play, and if I recall correctly, the Tapu Lily is healthy enough to live a hit from Reuniclus. And I don't think this Reuniclus has recover, so there's no way for Reuniclus to get healthy again. Oh, okay. So basically what Ray had to do there was he trick roomed again because he wanted to trick, because his trick room would end soon otherwise. Let's say Black Oblivion would switch out into Tapu Lily. I think the trick room would soon end, and if trick room ends and the Lily dies and then Tita comes in, Ray loses. So what he had to try to do is reset the trick room. I think the reason the Gastrodon was faster is because trick room resets when the turn you go for trick room. Trick room has negative priority. That's where trick room went after, right? So he had to try to reset the trick room and set up the trick room again because he had to have trick room still up to outspeed a Tita. So thank you guys for watching and peace out.